Yeah, I am Dr. Sanjay Kumar Divekar from Department of Chemistry, KLS Gopte Institute of Technology, Belgavi. What are polymers? Polymers are large molecules formed by the repeated linkages of small molecules called monomers. Now, word polymer is originated from two Greek words. Poly means many and mers means parts. How these polymers are classified? Now, polymers are classified in different ways. The first way of classification of polymers is natural and synthetic polymers. This classification is based on how these polymers are available. If the polymers are available from natural sources, we call them natural polymer. Example is cotton. Synthetic polymers are those which are derived from monomers, which are mainly petrochemicals. Example is polyvinyl chloride, where vinyl chloride is the monomer, which on polymerization gives a polymer, polyvinyl chloride. Second way of classification of polymers is addition and condensation polymers. Now, this classification is based on mode of synthesis of polymers. Addition polymers are those which are formed by simple addition of monomers of identical or different chemical structure without elimination of byproduct. Whereas condensation polymers are those which are formed by stepwise condensation reaction between monomers of identical or different chemical structure. Now, addition polymer example is polyethylene, where ethylene is a monomer. When it polymerizes by addition polymerization process, you get polyethylene. Whereas nylon 6,6 is a condensation polymer because it is formed by stepwise condensation reaction between hexamethylene diamine and adipic acid. Third way of classification of polymers is thermoplastic and thermosetting polymers. Now, this classification is based on action of heat on polymeric materials. Now, thermoplastics are those which polymeric materials, when molded, once they take the shape of the mold, reshaping, recycling is possible because the changes which are involved are purely physical in nature. In case of thermosetting polymers are polymeric materials which on molding, once they set into a hard mass after the molding process, reshaping, recycling is not possible because the changes which are involved are purely chemical in nature. Additional crosslinks and branches are formed. Fourth way of classification of polymers is plastics, fibers, elastomers, and liquid resins. Now, this is based on how the polymers are converted finally into a finished product. Plastics are those polymeric materials when they are molded into a finished product, they become hard and tough. We call them plastics. Polymeric materials, when they are converted into fiber, we call them fibers. Polymeric material, if they are converted into a elastomer having elastic characteristic, we call them elastomers. And polymeric materials which are available in liquid form as adhesives, we call them liquid resins. Fifth way of classification of polymers is homopolymers and copolymers. Now, this classification is based on how the monomer units are linked together in a polymer chain. If the monomers of identical chemical structure are linked together to form a long chain, then it is homopolymer. If the monomers of different chemical structure are there in the main chain, then we call it as copolymer. Sixth way of classification of polymer is linear, branched, and cross-linked polymers. Now, this classification is based on structure of the polymer. Now, linear chain polymers are those where monomeric units are linked together to form a long chain. Whereas branched chain polymers, where The monomers, many units are linked together in a long chain. In addition to that, there are side branches also. Whereas cross-linked polymers are those where, in addition to the different chains, there are some cross-linkages in between the chains. We call them cross-linked polymers. Now we will see some questions connected to the polymer chemistry which are asked frequently in CET. Now the first question is, polymers which undergo extensive cross-linking or heating results in formation of three-dimensional network R. Now there are four options: thermoplastic polymers, thermosetting polymers, addition polymers and copolymers. Now already I have told, thermosetting polymers are those which on molding, once they set into a hard mass, remolding, recycling is not possible. So the correct option is thermosetting polymers. Next, which of the following is not a condensation polymer? Already I have discussed what are condensation polymers. Polymerization which takes place in stepwise manner with the elimination of a byproduct. There are four options given. One is, first one is bakelite, second polyester, third one nylon 66, fourth one polyethylene. So bakelite is a polymer which is formed by the condensation reaction between phenol and formaldehyde, whereas polyester is a condensation polymer formed by the reaction between ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid. Nylon 66 is a condensation polymer which is formed by a reaction between hexamethylene diamine and adipic acid. And last one is polyethylene, which is formed by simple addition polymerization of ethylene. So the correct answer is polyethylene. Next question. Which of the following monomer on polymerization gives polymer neoprene? Now neoprene is a synthetic rubber. Now there are four options given. The first one is butadiene. Second one is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Third one is 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. And fourth one is vinyl chloride. Now as you know, neoprene is a commercial name of a polymer, polychloroprene. So the correct answer is third one, that is chloroprene. When it polymerizes, it forms polychloroprene. That is how this chloroprene is formed. Last question connected to polymers, what is the percentage of sulfur used in vulcanization of rubber? Now as you know, vulcanization is the process of addition of sulfur to the rubber just to increase its elastic behavior. Now four options are given: 5%, 3%, 30% and 55%. Now as you increase the sulfur content in rubber, the elasticity also increases, but if it is more, rubber becomes very hard and we call it as ebonite. So the correct percentage of sulfur required in the vulcanization process is 5% in natural rubber as well as synthetic rubber. Thank you.